surfing is when a hang glider pilot, while flying his hang glider, lands on the glider of another hang glider pilot while he's flying his glider. At the same time, that hang glider pilot is flying with a hang glider pilot on top of his glider, flying a glider.
Chris, last year was the first time we discovered windsurfing here at Funston, and that was incredible. This year, windsurfing has become ridiculous, with durations of over 45 minutes and moves like sitting down, kneeling down, lying down on the top of another glider.
More people are getting interested in the sport because it seems to be a lot of fun for one and safer than it looks.
As far as safety goes,
I'm not going to get close to anybody I don't feel is aware of what's going on. Like, there are a lot of pilots out here that I wouldn't get anywhere near them.
Dingo can come in very aggressive, and not all approaches are perfect. So if it's not directly lined up, or if I'm off to one side, perhaps if I bounce on my knees or get too far back, I'll yell out a safety word that we all use, which is brake. I feel better about kicking his nose cone off because Chris was there and he was the available in-air repair.
When the two of us were flying docked right next to Chris and Emily, that was pretty cool. We actually had four people flying docked right next to each other, so that was a really fun moment.
I was able to kneel down on the glider, put my hands in front of the base tube, and put them together as if I was praying. Called that move on a wing and a prayer.
Amen.
The feeling of standing on the nose of another glider while it's flying is an incredible experience. You can control it with just slight pressures of your feet, yawing it side to side, pitching it up and down with pressure on your knees and feet. One day this summer we had a plan to get all of us in the air at once. We all met at the picnic table to discuss the possibilities, have cameras everywhere. Dingo had smoke canisters we were gonna put on our gliders. Maybe there would be a triple. There was sun out. The wind was perfect. Turned out the day was great.
After we had two gliders stabilized for long periods of time, over 20 minutes at this point, we decided that maybe three would be a good idea.
I could tell that bottom person wasn't really going to be able to do anything, and they were just kind of dangling their feet down, and it was going to be up to me to do anything if I, you know, was able to get close.
Chris finally points out that Dingo is under us because I'm looking at him naturally.
Put your feet out, Emily!
So when I'm laying down on the wing, I have the leading edge in one hand and my bass tube in the other, and I can manipulate both gliders very easily.
Once we had practiced our wingsurfing skills at Funston, we decided it was time to take the show on the road.
This was flying perfectly stable, and we just slowly inched in just like we did at the coast and came in underneath each other. And those final few feet as we looked up and we realized everything was perfect. It was almost one of the smoothest docks we've ever done. We saw the speeds come in together and close, and it was perfect.
When we first docked, Dingo wanted me to sit down right away. He said, "Sit down!" And I said, "No, I want to do linebacker." So I reached down, grabbed the leading edge with my hand, did the linebacker for about 20 seconds, and then sat down and put my feet on his wires. They docked the whole way across the valley from Glacier Point to Yosemite Falls. Through Yosemite Falls, I did a couple of moves. I did Wing and a Prayer, and then we split apart, and it was a really successful trip, I thought.
How was it, Chris?
Awesome. Docked up in Yosemite, all the way across the valley.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got it going.
Thanks for calling. Goodbye.